Today's topic is role of infection control committee in hospital. It is the very right time to discuss about the role of infection control committee because we all are facing the pandemic COVID-19 right now. So all the hospitals are totally depend on the directions of infection control committee. So how this committee is very much important. How this committee is framing policies in hospital and safeguard the patients and the healthcare professionals in various way and protect from infection spreading from hospital. That all we are going to discuss in this topic. The infection means the risk of infection is always present in every hospital. This infection is maybe brought from outside or acquired from inside the hospital. The two way we can classify these infections. Patient may acquire infection before admission to the hospital. A COVID-19 patient you take, they are admitted with infection, they are coming to hospital. And in the hospital, inpatients, there may be with other problems, the already admitted patients will be there. There is a chance for contamination among the patients. The disease may spread. That is possibilities. So what are the measures to be taken? How the patients can be isolated according to the seriousness, and how the healthcare professionals can handle the patients carefully to safeguard themselves also. So all these guidelines will be given by, initiated by the committee called Infection Control Committee. Patients may get infected inside the hospital also, because regularly infected patients are coming, visiting and going. So infections, those who are coming to hospital only may acquire, and while after discharge that may show some symptoms, or when admitted at the time also it may show some symptoms. So that type of infections are called nosocomial infection. Patients who acquired infections from the hospital is called hospital-borne infections, are called nosocomial infection. It includes infection not present nor incubating at admission. During admission, there is no infection. Once after admission, few days after, this problem started. Infections that appear more than 48 hours after admission, and those acquired in the hospital but appear after discharge. Also, occupational infection among staff. These all called as nosocomial infections. Infection, how we can define? Injurious contamination of body or parts of the body by bacteria, viruses, fungi, protozoa, rickettsia, or by the toxins that they may produce. Infection may be local or generalized and spread throughout the body. Once the infectious agent enters the host, it begins to proliferate and reacts with the defense mechanisms of the body, producing infection symptoms and signs, pain, swelling, redness, functional disorders, raise in body temperature and pulse rate, and leukocytosis. So these all are collectively known as, called as infection. Frequency of nosocomial infection. The hospital-borne infection, nosocomial infection, occurs worldwide. It is a worldwide problem. Higher in developing countries' hospitals. The incidence is about 5 to 8% of hospitalized patients, 1/3 of which is preventable, treatable and preventable. The highest frequencies are in East Mediterranean countries and Southeast Asian countries. There it is high. The high frequency of nosocomial infection is evidence of poor quality health services delivered. So it is an indicator of quality of service. If it is high rate, it indicates the quality of service provided is poor. So it indicates that there should be a proper monitoring system to document all these problems and to attend all these problems and to make policies to eradicate completely this nosocomial infection. For that, we need one committee. Factors influencing nosocomial infections are the microbial agents, patient susceptibility, environmental factor. Microbial agents. some drugs we are prescribing repeatedly that may create resistance among the microbes. So that become useless, and we are repeatedly believing on those antibiotics only. So such irrational prescriptions creates resistance that leads to infection, hospital-borne infections. Patient susceptibility also a reason, and environmental factors also. The changes in environment may result some mutations among the microbes, and they develop resistance among them. Transmissions, how it is spreading. Where do nosocomial infection comes from? Endogenous infection, when normal patient flora changes to pathogenic bacteria because of change of normal habitat, damage of skin and inappropriate antibiotic use, about 50% of the nosocomial infections are caused by this way because of the irrational prescriptions. Pathogenic bacteria, because of change in normal habitat, so they may develop a new resistance. And exogenous factors, cross infections, mainly through hands of healthcare workers, visitors and patients. Now we are all recommending hand wash for minimum 20 seconds. We have to wash with soaps. We are telling for to prevent COVID-19 problems. It is applicable for all the problems. Through the hand only, many of the infections are spreading. So hand wash should be insisted, should be followed. Criteria of nosocomial infection. Criteria of nosocomial infections are surgical site infection, any purulent discharge, abscess, or spreading cellulitis at the surgical site during the month after operation. So that is one type of infection that indicates infection after surgery. Urinary infection, positive urine culture. It shows one or two species with at least 10 lakh bacteria per ml with or without clinical symptoms. This is called urinary infection. Respiratory infections means respiratory symptoms with at least two signs, cough, purulent sputum, new infiltrate on chest appearing during hospitalization. So that indicates respiratory infection started. Vascular catheter infection, inflammation, lymphangitis, or purulent discharge at the insertion site. So at the site of catheter insertion, infection started. Septicemia, fever or rigorous, and at least one positive blood culture that indicates septicemia is present. So these are the possible nosocomial infections in this various way. Infection control program, how we can control in hospital. The important components are basic measures, standards, and additional precautions we have to develop in hospital. Education and training of healthcare workers, we have to give regularly, we have to update their knowledge. Protection of healthcare workers by you providing PPE like personal protective equipments and masks, hand gloves. All we have to, sanitizers, all we have to provide, and we have to give immunizations to the workers if it is available. Identification of hazards and minimizing risks. We have to identify at the right time. Informations to be collected through proper channel. Routine practices such as aseptic techniques, handling and use of blood and blood products, waste management, use of single-use devices. So like this various way, we can prevent infections. And we have to maintain some monitoring system, surveillance programs. So continuously monitor how the procedures are going on in hospital properly or not, and whether any modifications required. Incident monitoring. So any incident occur in hospital, like any infections, possible infections are found in hospital, that information is to be immediately collected and discussed, and necessary steps, preventive measures to be taken. And we have to update our knowledge by continuously doing research on various infections and preventive measures. Basics of infection control. Prevention of nosocomial infection is the responsibility of all individuals and services provided by healthcare setting. To practice good asepsis, one should always know what is dirty, what is clean, what is sterile, and keep them separate. So these knowledge everyone should know, sanitary workers to the treating doctors, everyone should know. Hospital policies and procedures are applied to prevent spread of infections in hospital. So that policy is to be adapted very strictly in hospital. Goals for infection control and hospital epidemiology. There are three principal goals for hospital infection control and prevention programs. One is protect the patient. That is the first goal. Protect the healthcare workers is the next goal. Visitors and others in the healthcare environment. That is why visitors not allowed they are telling. Visitors may bring many contaminations from outside. So protect the healthcare workers and visitors is the secondary goal. Tertiary goal is accomplish the previous two goals in a cost-effective, cost-efficient manner whenever possible. So necessary policies to be made to implement that two first primary and secondary goals in a cost-effective manner. Always it should be in practice in hospital. That is the third tertiary goal. Role of infection control committee. Now we are coming to the topic. Review and approve surveillance and prevention program is the role of main role of infection control committee. Review and approve surveillance program, a monitoring program in hospital, how things are going on. A team will always function, gather information. So they will modify the procedures and suggest. So this is called review and approve surveillance program. That is the main role of ICC. Identify areas for intervention where necessary attention to be shown. That is, that areas will be identified. To assess and promote improved practices at all levels of health facility. So what are the facilities required? All will be provided to the healthcare professionals. To ensure appropriate staff training. Training is important. COVID-19, how it spreads. Every day, one new informations we are gathering from the learnings. So that information is to be passed to the healthcare community and proper training to be given. Safety management. How we can safely handle the wastages. We are safely handle patients. Safely handle the patient admitted wards, containment zones. So like that informations. These are called safety management. Development of policies for the prevention and control of infection. To develop its own infection control manual. So they will give guidelines. Time to time they will update in the form of a printed material. They circulate among the educated healthcare professionals. So that is called infection control manual. Monitor and evaluate the performance of program. How it is going on. So these are the role of infection control committee in a hospital. Function and organization of the infection control program. How this organization setup is developed throughout the world and how things are going on worldwide. We see the provision of an effective infection control program is a key to the quality and a reflection of the overall standards of care provided by the healthcare institution. So we are telling this hospital quality was very good. How? Because they are having such a very strong infection control programs. So they are maintaining patients' health and safety and the healthcare professional safety with high priority. They take care. So the growth in ICP has been paralleled by the establishment and growth of a number of professional and governmental organizations which focus on nosocomial infection prevention and control. Thus, the professional bodies which are functioning and for the with the aim of controlling infection throughout the world is, for example, APIC is one organization, SHEA, CDC, HICPAC. This is the full form. APIC means Association for Professionals in Infection Control and Epidemiology. It is an functioning in USA. All these four are connected to USA. Now their policies are very popular and throughout the world they are following their principles also. So Association of Professionals in Infection Control and Epidemiology, they are doing continuously research on the infections, how preventions and training, everything. SHEA is Society for Healthcare Epidemiology of America. CDC is very popular nowadays, we know very well. The CDC only recommends chloroquine, hydroxychloroquine can be used. The CDC only recommends 2 meter distance to be maintained among the social groups. So like that. It is very popular in America. They are the only guiding agency to prevent diseases. So the Center for Disease Control and Prevention, CDC, is a popular organization, involves the aim of infection control. HACPESE is the Healthcare Professional Control Practices Advisory Committee. So like that, many professional organizations are there. So we can take the guidelines in our hospital also. We can adopt those policies. Infection Control Program, ICP, in the majority of countries, typically operates on two levels. There is a program, ICP, developed by these previously discussed professional organizations. And these programs to be implemented among the hospital staff and patients. How it is possible means in two ways it is possible. We have to develop one executive body and we have to develop one advisory body. Executive body is called Infection Control Team, ICT. Advisory body is called Infection Control Committee, ICC. So there are two bodies, they are monitoring this program. Infection Control Team, ICT, and advisory body in the Hospital Management Infection Control Committee, which adopts the legislative role of policy making. So the ICC only develops policies, so compulsorily all the staff should follow that. Okay, first executive body, ICT, Infection Control Team is what? The optimal structure varies with hospitals, types, need and resources. So different different type of setup is followed to develop this team in hospital to hospital. It depends on the size of the hospital and their objective of the hospital. The hospital can appoint epidemiologist or infectious disease specialist, microbiologist to work as infection control physician. The infection control nurse, ICN, who is interested and has experience in infection control issues can be appointed in this team. So infection control physician, infection control nurse, they are the part of infection control team. Infection control program also recommends an making of an advisory body, that is infection control committee. It is a multidisciplinary committee responsible for monitoring program policies, implementation and recommend corrective actions. In the previous discussion we have discussed about pharmacy and therapeutic committee, PTC. This is also a committee. This is also have powers to develop policies and to implement and monitor the policies practices in hospital. It includes representatives from different concerned hospital department and management. They meet bimonthly. 2 months once they conduct meeting. It establishes standards for patient care. It reviews and assess IC reports, infection control reports, and identifies areas of intervention. So where the attention to be shown, all will be identified by this ICC. The hospital infection control program is functioning like this. Part of the program is maintained by infection control team, and as per the direction of the team, infection control committee is functioning. An infection control manual is developed, so based on that may list the guidelines. So all, that is the printed document of the policies developed in this hospital. Infection control committee members, how they are appointed. We are studying under hospital pharmacy subject, this infection control committee. So we should understood that the role of pharmacist also there in this committee. The members of the hospital ICC should reflect the spectrum of clinical services and administrative managements of the healthcare facility. As a minimum, the committee should include chief executive or hospital administrator nominator as a nominator representative. So because we are developing a policy, so that should be comes under the knowledge of the hospital administration. So they are the primary member of the committee, chief executive. And then ICD or infection control doctor or hospital microbiologist will be the chairperson of the committee. Chief of all the major clinical department, all HODs of the department will be other members. So they are all physicians. Then infection control nurse, ICN, their role is very important because they are only involving in patient care. So they are the people, they are the healthcare professionals going to implement the policies everywhere in the wards. Next role is chief pharmacist, also plays important role and identify various ways to control, prevent infections from their level. And head of the maintenance and cleaning department, their role is very much important in hospital to prevent infections. A director of central sterile supply department, we know very well in a revision class, again we discuss about the role of central sterile supply services in hospital. That is totally managed by pharmacists in hospital. So sterilization prevents microbial infections, that all we know. So all these departments jointly make a committee that is only called infection control committee. Team members to be authorized. So the team should have authority to manage an effective control program. Team should have a direct reporting with senior administration. Infection control team members are responsible for day-to-day functions of infection control and preparing the early work plan. They should be expert and creative in their job. So that is their responsibilities. Functions. Functions of infection control committee, what they will do. So this committee will implement infection control policies. So they will discuss among themselves, identify crucial areas and how the policies to be adopted in a hospital to prevent further infections. All they will discuss and implement. So that become the legislative orders in the hospital. So all should follow, that is called policies. Then supervision of standards of professional care in regards to infection. So they develop standards. For example, alcohol sanitizers. How much percentage of alcohol minimum it should contain as a sanitizer. Usage of sodium hypochlorite in hospitals as a sanitizer. Whether it is can work against microbes like virus or it won't work. There are a lot of research is going on. Government is time to time changing policies. The effect of calcium hypochlorite sprinkling everywhere, how it effective against virus spread. So like that information we are getting from news nowadays. This all developed by infection control organizations by their regular research. Education and orientation programs for professional staff. That is very much important. How it is spreading, how we can safeguard, whether this PPE is effective, how long we can use one gloves, how we should replace, how we should wear our mask, how we can remove our mask. So all these informations we have to educate. Surveillance of hospital acquired infections. How it developed, how long it is there. After discharge or during admission itself, patients are getting developed. How it is spreading, all these information is to be collected. Surveillance of health staff health. So the proper immunizations to be provided to them. Standards of hospital domestic cleaning and food services hygiene that should be monitored. Management of visitors in isolation circumstances. How we can control extraneous infections. Matters of general hospital organization and purchasing where these may affect infection control. So that is maintained majorly by the pharmacist. What are the necessary equipments to be purchased and their standards. Establishment and supervision of infection control team. That is the administrative role. Submit an activity report and statistical data to the central committee every 6 months. So we can assess ourselves how we are effective against infection control. So these are the functions. In exam, we may get 5-mark questions of in role of infection control committee in hospital. So all these discussed points are the answers for this question. The ICC has the following task to review the same thing, only additional points, to review and approve annual plan of infection control. So every year we have to discuss and review the policies. We should not follow the same old principles. To review and approve the infection control policies, and after revision it should be approved for implementation. To support the IC team and direct resources to address problems as identified. So now onwards, see, because of this new infection spreading throughout the globe, all the hospitals definitely they may have reviewed policies on infection control. So nobody will follow the old policies. So this is the time to review everybody's policies. So it is a regular practice in hospital. The support to support the IC team and direct resources to address problems as identified. Some of the hospitals have a very shortage of PPE, personal protective equipments. We are getting in news. So such hospitals will report to the IC. That is the job of infection control committee to assess that problem. We have to address the problem and we have to provide necessary equipments at the right time. It is their job to ensure availability of appropriate supplies, to review epidemiological surveillance data and identify area of for prevention. So which are the antibiotics are necessary, stocks to be kept and that should be purchased. All informations they may get passed to administration of the hospital. They will arrange that. Okay. We will close this discussion now. We discuss further in our next class. I stop recording now.